shall never adjust my approach to this maze. I shall never falter to the end of my day. Though I must die many times.
I'm sorry. your repentance by the fruit it bears, and do not presume to say to yourselves,
we have Abraham for our father.
For I tell you that God can make children for Abraham out of these stones here. Already the axe has been laid to the roots of the trees, and those which fail to produce good fruit shall be cut down and thrown on the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance. But he who comes after me is mightier than I. I'm not fit to untie his shoe. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Do you come to me?
Yeah, I want to get washed up.
No, it is I who needs to come to you.
No, look, let it be so for the present. We do well now to perform with all that God requires. When wilt thou save the people, O God of mercy, when the people, Lord, the people, not thrones and crowns, but men, flowers of thy heart, O God, are they? Let them not pass like weeds away. Their heritage, a sunless day. God save the people, shall trembling cry forever, strength fading, still be strong. Is it thy will, O Father, that man shall toil for wrong? O thou say thy mountains, thou say thy sky, that thy sun shall rise. And songs we heard
Now, do not suppose I come to abolish the law and the prophets. I come not to abolish, but to complete. So long as heaven and earth endure, not a letter, not a stroke of the law will disappear until all that must happen has happened. If any man therefore sets aside even the least of the law's commands, he will have the lowest place in the kingdom of heaven. But he who keeps the law and teaches others so, he will have the highest place in the kingdom of heaven. Unless you show yourselves far better men than the Pharisees and the doctors of the law. Hey, baby!
Thank you.
Otherwise, he'll hand you over to the judge. The judge to the constable, and you'll land in jail. But I'll tell you, you'll not get out of jail until you've paid the last penny.
I pray to see thee more clearly.
need shaft time to fix it.
If you're right, I offend you. I want you to tear it out and fling it away.
Yeah, right.
It's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell.
Yeah, but she's so...
If your left hand offends you, I want you to cut it off and fling it away.
Get real.
It's better for you to lose one part of your body than for the whole of it to be thrown into hell. You've learned that they were told, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. What I tell you is this. Never set yourself against the man who wrongs you. So if someone slaps you on your right cheek, I want you to turn and offer your left.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you.
Your goodness must know no bounds, just as our heavenly Father knows no limits. But be careful not to make a show of your religion. For if you do, no reward awaits you in the kingdom of my Father. So when you do an act of charity, don't announce with a flourish of trumpets as the heathen do in the synagogues and in the streets. I tell you, they do it just to win admiration from men. Though when you do some act of charity, never let your right hand know what your left hand is doing.
What the good master is telling us is that when God tells a little secret on us, he knows that we...
No. God, who sees what is done in secret, he will what?
Reward you!
There once was a rich man who dressed in purple and all the finest linen.
That's me.
And every day feasted in the greatest magnificence. And at his gate there lay a poor man named Lazarus.
I would gladly pay you Tuesday for a hamburger today.
One day the poor man died. But was carried away by the angels to be with Abraham.
Come on up here, Lazarus.
The rich man. And there, far, far away, was Abraham, with Lazarus close beside him.
Oh, Father Abraham, said Lazarus, and dip the tip of his finger in water to cool my tongue.
Remember, my child, all the good things fell to you while you were on earth, and all the bad to poor dear Lazarus. Now to see who's in consolation here, and you who are an enemy. But that ain't all, either. There's a great chasm between us, and nobody your side who wants to cross the can, and no one from our side who wants to cross the can either.
Then, Father, at least send Lazarus to my father's house, where I have five brothers to warn them so we won't come to this place of torment.
They've got Moses and the prophet. Let them listen to them.
But if someone from the dead should arrive, they would listen.
Excuse me. But if they ain't going to listen to Moses and the prophets, they ain't going to listen to nobody. Not even if someone should rise from the dead.
You know what? That's a real good lesson.
I think we should tell them out there about it.
Hey, yeah!
I can see a swath of sinners sitting yonder, and they're acting like a pack of fools. Gazing into space, they left their minds all worn instead of studying the good Lord's rule. You better pay attention, build comprehension. There's gonna be a quiz at your ascension, not to mention any threat of hell. But if you're smart, you'll learn your lessons well.
Or he'll be devoted to the second and think nothing of the first. No man can serve God.
What?
And money. Spin. And yet I tell you, Solomon, in all his splendor, was not attired like one of these. If that's how God clothes the grass which is here today, and tomorrow is thrown on the fire, will he not all the more clothe you?
I don't think so.
How little faith you have. Don't go around anxiously saying,
what am I to eat? What am I to eat? What are we to eat?
Set your mind where?
God.
God's kingdom and his justice and all the rest will come to you as well. So don't worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has problems of its own.
That's right.
of God. And that which fell along the footpath, they hear the word, but then the devil comes and carries them off. Here they should believe and be saved. That which fell among the rock, they receive the word with joy when they first hear it, but they have no root, so in time of testing they desert. Now that which fell among the weeds, they hear the word, but their further growth is impaired by cares and pleasures of the world. That which fell among the good soil, they hear the word with a good and honest heart. Through times of perseverance, yield bountiful harvest. Woo!
Bring the fatted calf and kill it, a nice kosher one. For today my son was lost and is found.
And the festivity is the day!
Now the other shirt is out the field working.
Woo!
It's hot out here. And as he approached the house, he heard music. He called to one of the servants.
Yes! What's all this partying going on?
Your cousin? No. Your brother-in-law?
No. Your nephew?
No.
I don't know. Oh, come on, tell me.
Okay, let me think.
Your brother?
Yeah, that's it.
He's come home, and your father has killed the fatted calf because he has him back safe and sound.
You've got to be kidding!
No.
Well, the son's a right fit. He refused to go into the house. The father came out and pleaded with him, but he retorted, saying,
I don't believe this. Stop! You know how I've worked for you all these years. I never once disobeyed your orders. You never even gave me so much as a kid.
That's baby goat to you guys. Poor beast with my friends.
But when Carrie turns up after running through all your money with his women and booze and fine clothes and Range Rovers, and you kill the fat calf for her?
You have always been with me, and all that I have is yours. I have killed the fattest calf because today is the day to celebrate. For your brother was dead and has come back to life.
Metaphorically speaking, was lost and is found.
No way!
Way!
A killer!
Something kind of cool. not to mention any threat of hell. But if you're smart, you learn your lessons well.
Thank you.
answer it, and then I'll tell you by whose authority I act. The baptism of John, was it from God or from man?
If we say it was from God, then he will say, then why do not believe?
And if we say it was from man, then the people will be angry, because they took John as a prophet.
We cannot say.
Then neither will I tell you by whose authority I act. But I have a story for you. A man had two sons. He went to the first son and said,
my son, go and work in the field today.
Okay, Pop,
said the boy, but he never went. The man went to his second son and said,
my son, go and work in the field today.
No way, I'm gonna...
Which of these two did as his father wished?
The second, obviously. Yeah.
I tell you this, tax gatherers and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of heaven. For when John came and showed you the right way of life, you did not listen. But the tax gatherers and prostitutes did. Even when you saw this, you did not follow.
Master, you're an honest man. Give us your ruling on this. Are we or are we not permitted to pay all our taxes to the Roman Emperor?
Yeah. You hypocrite!
Show me the money in which the tax is paid. Well now, whose head is on here? Whose inscription?
Caesar!
And pay Caesar what is due Caesar. But pay God what is God's.
Master, what is the greatest commandment of them all?
Thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul. This is the greatest commandment of them all, and the second one is like it. Love thy neighbor as thyself. All the rest of the law is based on these first two. Be excellent, everybody. Party on! But the lawyers and Pharisees sit in the chair of Moses. Listen to what they say, but do not follow their practices. For they say one thing and mean another. They make heavy laws and pile them on man's shoulders, never lifting a finger to carry the load themselves. Everything they do is done for show. They want to be greeted respectfully, to be called teacher. But you must not be called teacher, for there is but one teacher, and he is a Messiah. No man on earth shall be called father, for there is but one, and you are all brothers. No man shall be called rabbi, for there is one, and he is in heaven. Alas, alas, you lawyers and Pharisees, hypocrites that you be, searching for souls and fools to forsake them to travel the land, scour the sea. Then when you've got your converts, make them twice as fit for hell as you are yourselves. Alas, alas, for you lawyers and Pharisees, hypocrites that you are, sure that the kingdom of heaven awaits you, you will not venture half so far. Other men who might enter the gates you keep from passing through, drag them down with you. You snakes, you viper's brood, cannot escape me, devil's food. I send you prophets and I send you preachers, sages and rages and angels and teachers, nothing to bar your mood. Alas, alas, you lords and Pharisees, hypocrites to a man. Sons of the dogs who murdered the prophets, finishing off what your fathers began. You don't have time to scorn or scoff, it's getting very late. Vengeance doesn't wait. You snakes, you viper's brood, cannot escape being devil's food. I send you prophets and I send you creatures, sages and rages and ages and teachers, nothing bar your mood. Blind guides, blind fools, the blood you've spilled on you will fall. This nation, this generation, shall bear the guilt of it all. Alas, 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 you blind fools! stones the prophets and murders the messengers sent to her. How often have I longed to gather your children as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, but you would not let me. So I tell you, you shall never see me until the time when you say, blessing on him who comes in the name of the Lord. Take care that no one misleads you, for many will come in my name, saying, I am the Messiah, and many will be misled by them. The sounds of battle will be heard near at hand. Nation will make war upon nation, kingdom upon kingdom. There will be famines and earthquakes. But among all these sounds, birth pangs of a new age will begin.
Happy Noah's Day!
So they will be when the Son of Man comes.
Come on in, most of the satellites have 93% chance of rain.
For in the days before the flood, men ate and drank and married and knew nothing until the flood came and swept them all away.
So the penguins came. The tigers came. The kangaroos came. The bears came. The chickens came. The snakes came. The lambs came. The vultures came. And the elephants came with Noah.
For my hand is cold and needs
called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What will you give me to betray him?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that day on, he began to look for an opportunity to betray.
By my side.
Please.
words are yours. Do quickly what you have to do. Take this and eat. This is my body. Take this and drink. This is my blood. Blood which was shed for the forgiveness of sins. And I tell you, I'll not again drink from the fruit of the vine until I drink it again with you in the kingdom of my Father. Thank you. He lives on every word that God utters.
If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down. For the scripture has written, he will send his angels and they will hold you in their arms.
Do not tempt the Lord your God.
All these things I will give you if you will do me homage.
Be gone, Satan. You will do homage to the Lord your God and worship him alone. Friend, do quickly what you have to do. Stop! Put down the sword. He who lives by the sword dies by the sword. Do you not suppose I could appeal to my father, who would at once send 12 legions of angels to come after me? Day after day I sat teaching in the synagogues, and he didn't come. But all that happens will fulfill what the prophets have written.
Thank you. feel free to hug the cast members. They really like that.